Only 10 times before, this is the 11th, has the Canadian Judicial Council convened a hearing into the conduct of one of its own. This one is the 11th, and it started at a hearing room in Calgary, and it's examining the conduct, really the remarks made by Federal Court of Canada Judge Robin Camp. Now, it wasn't in his capacity as a federal court judge that Judge Camp landed himself in this hot water, but rather before his elevation to the High Court when he was sitting as a provincial court judge in Alberta. He was hearing a sexual assault case in 2014, I think. He's sort of colloquially known, unfortunately, as the why couldn't you keep your knees together judge, for lack of a better description. That is one of the questions he asked the then 19-year-old complainant in this sexual assault case called R versus Wagar. In the end, Judge Camp acquitted Mr. Wagar, who was the accused, but it's not his decision in law so much that is at issue here. It's rather, and this is what makes it such a compelling case, it's not what he did, but rather what he said, the language he used, and what that revealed or didn't reveal about his attitudes towards women, sex, and the law. You may recall this case because of the nature of his remarks. It was all over the world, I think, to some degree. And he could lose his job because of that. And in fact, the presenting counsel, Marjorie Hickey, told the hearing committee today that the issue isn't whether Robin Camp has or can reform his thinking, but rather whether the judiciary can remedy the damage done to it without firing him. That's basically what she said. She's the prosecutor, basically. She's calling only one witness, and that witness came and went already today. She is the young woman, now 24, who was at the center of the original allegation of sexual assault. And she came to tell the judges and the two lawyers who formed this committee that, you know, she was hurt and shattered and rendered suicidal by some of the things that happened in that courtroom. She said the judge made her feel, worthless and all of that. As she's talking, very flushing as she read her, what is the equivalent of a victim impact statement. She flushed, she had difficulty looking at the body of the court, but she nonetheless managed to get through it. And she thanked you guys, as she put it, rather endearingly, meaning the CJC, for taking this subject on and trying to change things. That's it from Calgary. I'm Christy Blatchford.